Some dashboards help you make decisions. Others just give you a headache. Let's learn how to build the first kind. First things first, what's the job of a dashboard? It's not to look cool. It's not to dump every data point you have into a single screen. The goal is clarity. Your dashboard should show users what matters most, without them needing to dig. So here's how we do it at Eleken. Start with context. Ask, what decisions will the user make here? Are they tracking performance, watching real-time changes, or looking for trends? Based on that, you'll know if you're building an analytical, strategic, or operational dashboard. Analytical dashboards are for digging deep into data, spotting patterns, forecasting. Think product usage trends over time. Strategic dashboards are more high-level, KPIs, big picture stuff. Operational dashboards are real-time ones. How many tickets are open, how the current campaign performing, you get the idea. Next up, understand the user. Don't assume you and your user think the same way. Ask who they are. What metrics do they care about? What's success for them? Are they data savvy or not? These answers shape everything from what you include to how you visualize it. Now let's talk about the content itself. What goes in? Don't throw 50 metrics. You are not building a spreadsheet. Pick the key indicators, start the user's goals. Interview real users. What do they check first when they open the app? What decisions are they trying to make? Once you have those metrics, now it's time to visualize, but carefully. Use the right charts. You don't need to get fancy, here's a cheat sheet. Just show in one key number, use a big bold single value card. Want to show change over time? Use a line chart. Comparing categories, bar chart. Display on real-time status, use color-coded indicators or gauges. Have a lot of tabular data, use a table, but keep it minimal. And avoid classic mistake, pie charts everywhere. They look nice, but they are hard to compare visually. Only use them for a quick glance, with clear labels. Once your charts are picked, arrange them well. Use a grid, start from top left, where users look first, put the most critical metrics there. Group all edit items together, keep everything aligned, and avoid visual clutter. One rule we follow at Eleken, if the user needs to scroll, it's probably too much. A dashboard should be visible at glance. If you're adding more than fits, it's time to cut. Now, a few tips on making it actually look good without over-designing. Use consistent colors. Don't make one chart neon green and the next pale blue, unless there is a clear reason. Use color intentionally. Red for alerts, green for good trends. Keep your color language consistent. Limit the color palette. Too many colors equals chaos. Also, don't forget about typography. Choose fonts that are easy to read. Inter, Roboto, or SF Pro work great. Don't go wild with sizes or weights. Keep things clean, use font weight and size to show hierarchy, not just style. Now a big one, labels. Always label everything. Users shouldn't have to guess what a number means. If there is a formula behind it, add a tooltip or small caption. And don't use icons without text. We are not playing charades here. Let's take a quick example. We worked with a customer experience platform that needed to monitor real-time chat performance. Managers had to see agent load, response times, and satisfaction scores at a glance. We built an operational dashboard with color-coded charts, live refresh data, and clear groupings by team. No clutter, no guesswork, just actionable insights. That's the key. Your dashboard isn't just data. It's a tool to act faster. And hey, designing a dashboard isn't just about beauty. It's about business results. When your users can get what they need in under 10 seconds, they stick around. They trust your product, they make smarter decisions. If you need help building dashboards like that, Eleken's got your back. We design dashboards for SaaS teams in healthcare, data analytics, finance, you name it. From MVPs to full redesigns, we focus on usability, speed, and getting users to those key insights fast. So, next time you attempt to cram in 20 charts, take a breath. Ask what your user needs to know right now and design for that. If this helped, hit the like button, drop a comment with the worst dashboard you've ever seen. We love those. And don't forget to subscribe for more no-nonsense product design tips.